Endometriosis is an abnormal appearance of the endometrial glands. Endometrial glands is the tissue that grows inside the lining of the uterus that a woman has for menstrual periods. Normally it grows, it thickens in the lining of the uterus as the hormones decline toward the end of their menstrual period. They have a flow and then it regenerates again to make a place for a baby to grow inside the lining of the uterus. Endometriosis is where that tissue is then located outside of the uterus and down into the pelvis itself. It can be in the lower portions of the pelvis. It can be on the pelvic sidewall next to the ovaries and the tubes. It could be adjacent on the bladder, on the intestines, the appendix, pretty much all throughout the entire pelvic cavity. That tissue then responds to the hormones very similar to the menstrual lining of the endometrial cavity in that it grows and it stretches and it pulls and causes pain and discomfort. It can also lead to infertility and can also cause a lot of dyspareunia, which is painful intercourse. Quite often the ladies have very significant cyclic pain starting after their menstrual period, about 2 weeks after their menstrual period has started. Pain starts to build, starts to get worse all the way up until their menstrual period starts again for the next month. The first day is very uncomfortable and painful. And then they get better and the cycle starts itself all over again. This can also get to the point they have pain throughout the entire month so that there are no good days and they're all pretty much bad days. Typically women start to come see their gynecologist when they start noticing an increasing and worsening of the cyclic pelvic pain. We treat it based on patient symptoms. We treat it based on what their outcomes want to be, what their future plans are. If they're planning on childbirth in the near, or a childbirth experience in the near future, then we try to do everything we can to optimize that with non-steroidal pain medication, with some hormonal manipulation. Quite often these are associated with infertility and it requires us to do a laparoscopic procedure in order to eliminate the endometrial tissue that's in the pelvis, which can cause infertility also. If they are just not in wanting to have childbearing option in the near future, we try to suppress everything either with hormonal suppression using something that's called a gonadotropic agonist, which makes the lining of the uterus and makes the lining of the pelvis and basically the ovaries themselves all shut down. Basically putting them to a medical menopause. It works very well, but quite often the side effects are not tolerable. These are options that are available and per patient preference and for those that have future childbearing as an option. For those that do not want future childbearing, who have had their finished having their children, ultimately most ladies with endometriosis end up with a hysterectomy and removal of the ovaries for the ultimate treatment. Diagnosis is very tough because obviously you can't see inside the pelvis unless you take a scope, which is called a laparoscope, and make an incision in the belly button and place the scope into the pelvis to look around to see if you see the endometriosis. Up until then, it's just a high index of suspicion for the diagnosis if it doesn't respond to our routine suppression therapy with birth control pills and other hormones, then we move to the laparoscopy to confirm or exclude the diagnosis. And then the other treatment options start from there. Cure rates are very low ultimately. Most everything we do is temporizing in order to get the achieved effect of childbearing. And after childbearing is over with, generally a hysterectomy is what ultimately cures the process. If endometriosis is the cause of the chronic pelvic pain, a hysterectomy with an oophorectomy, which is removal of the ovaries, will alleviate her pain between 80 and 90% of the time. If there are other mitigating circumstances, then there's probably a 10 to 15% recurrence of the pelvic pain in the form of persistent cramps, colon spasms, etc.